Hello, it's Simon here, and we're going to paint the picture now. In the previous video, you saw how I prepared the ground with some of the mediums, and I've put the back most of the background. Now we're going to get into the detail. Now, with our little brush, just actually hasn't got any name on it. It's just a student brush that I found in a sale, so it's not really important on the quality of, well, it is. It was quite good quality. You just feel it. If it feels good enough, it's good enough quality. But what I mean, he hasn't got a name. It doesn't have to have a name. But I want to show you the technique of making these leaves here. I can see them, little leaf with a little point on there. It's actually done by just twisting like this, but I can show you on the using a bigger brush, if you, which is similar, or it can be like that. But it'd be nice to have a little bit of round, so you can make a little leaf like that. It's round here, and it goes off to a point like that and flicks off. So you go like that. You can actually see that I go like this and flick it off like that. So it's narrow there for the little point, and broader there. But for the back of the brush, it's best to use like a round edge, and then that can twist off. That's the best brush, like that. So that is what I've showed you with the larger ones, but that's got the same effect. It's got a flat bit there, and then it's a pointy bit if you twist it round. So I'm going to go like that and then pull up. Right, let's start on the painting. Just get some of the other paint. It's good to have one of these cloths just to clean off. And I've got some water over here. Can you see right in the corner there? And I've got my palette here, which if you want to keep, it's a stay wetter palette. Can see, I don't know if you can see. You can see it's got the wet foam. You can actually get some wet foam, and then dampen that, and then just put a piece of paper over the top, and just put it in a sealed container. You can get one of those Tupperware containers, or just make your own, or just put a top on, and it lasts longer. And I've got the mixture of what have we got? The flow, 1 to 10. One flow and water in a little spray, little spritzer spray, so you can spray over the thing, because even though that's open, the surface can actually dry off, especially if they're thin. So I've been using a bit of green that I've mixed up with a bit of blue and yellow, and there, got a little bit on there, and I'll just show you the full technique of how to do it. Right, you go like, put it down like that, and then twist up like that, and then that makes the leaf like that. We want a bit lighter actually, because we're going into the this part is all going to be quite bright. We want to show the leaf, so we need a little bit of white. Could be any make. I've just got a cheap student one there. It's got enough pigments. I think the professionals, you've got more pigment in the, but for white, you don't really need to be buying, especially if you use a lot of white. You're getting in these big tubes. Here we are, look. And if it's if you don't want to waste any, you can get one of these little. Put it in there, and then you twist it round like that, and it squeezes out really nice, so it doesn't waste any. But that's Winter Newton Professional. It's cheaper to buy in a really big container, but even be cheaper if you got not the professional, but the student range. Then it's just as good, Galera. But I'm gonna sell this painting slow. I'm going to use the best materials. A mixture of the background is mostly the cheaper. What we've got? Galera. It's not cheap as in cheap. It's a good quality, good pigment, but it's mainly for students. And but you can use it as a professional artist. You can put it on the background. So it doesn't. It's not. It doesn't turn out to be so expensive. And then I'm using the professional acrylic on the surface. It gives a bit more. The difference is it gives a bit more zing, a bit more color, a bit more pigment inside the tube. Okay, let's put some more leaves on. There we are. And if it's a bit dry, because this is dry from yesterday, I'm just starting again to complete the picture. Just get one of these. You don't want one that comes out with lots of big drops so it drips down. You want to try and get one that's as fine as you can get it. This is an air spray one, but you can actually buy them from online, professional versions, misters. So I'm going to spray that area there that I'm going to work on, and so I put actually too much on there, but so that's more. If you put that much on, that's really for fading and for mixing. But if I go up here away from where I've just did, you can see that it goes on nice and smoothly. If I do a few, you'll be able to see. And then just twist like that. A little bit darker, I think. What I'm doing, I'm going over some of these branches, so it looks like, there's leaves in front of the branches as well. And just get a little blob of it on here. Also, you can actually, because it's the first second part, you can actually see some of the pencil marks, which I don't want to show. So you can go those pencil marks with the and put a leaf. Might have to mix a bit more green up. There. Really, if I did a little bit of darker, you might be able to see them. It's quite because I'm going to get a faded color now. So if I mix in a little bit of blue and then do a few leaves, you might be able to see them go on. And just go in this corner here because that's quite light. If you look there, you can just do on the side of the and flick up. And gives that like leaf effect if you pull it up quickly. There you are. You see that there? Doesn't look just little dabs. And then once you get into it, you get a feel. You can't. You're less likely to make a lot of mistakes because you're doing so many kind of thing. You can actually, if you make one mistake, it gets lost, and the percentage that you get right because you're doing so many, like 100. If you get one or two not looking like leaves, if you're close up at them, it doesn't really matter as much because there's so many. If you get most of them right. And if you're looking for the leaves from a distance anyway, not all of them will, they'll be just little blobs. So the overall effect is the most important thing. There we are. And then I'm just going to keep bringing them in to the centre. Some of the leaves would go over the top of the other leaves as well, but I wanted the light to show through. and cover some of these branches. I'm going to spray them. So I want it a bit more fluid and get a little pool, and then pull it up and roll the thing. You can get a like nice little dab of show you there a bit closer, like. Not actually, isn't there's an, does it focus? I have to do it like that, and then it focuses. Actually, there's not much on there, but if you can see, there's enough to make about. I mean, I'll count them: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I think that's about it. About 20 I'd put on there. So it's filled quite a big area there. And I think we'll get a little bit more of a mixture going. I'm only using these Della Roni. It's got a good pigment in. As long as they've got a good bright pigment, you're happy with the pigment. That's the main thing. Right, let's mix up a little bit of green. I'm using blue, green, ultramarine, emerald green, and titanium white to make a nice little blotch of colour there. And that's come out neat now. And I just want it down like a couple of 10%. So if I go like that much, that like a thinner full of finger, like a little finger, but little blob. And then a couple of sprays, so you're not going over that the rule of 30% water, but it's got the fluid in there, 10 to 1, so it'll flow out. Ah, that's better. So it's getting a bit, they were getting a bit dry, and now it'll go on really nice, and you'll be able to see it better now. That's much better. See it blob, and they look more like leaves when you've got a big blob, nice little blob on you. I'll actually show you now. You'll be able to see this better. Look, see, it was dry before, now you've got a nice little blob on there. There, you can see that well now. It's well focused, you can see the shine. See how many that we get out of that. So what we're doing now, we're going in this area. So the end of these branches here are going to be lots of leaves. So we can just put quite a few. And big ones and small ones all coming out. So say that's that line like this. I'm starting here and pulling away like that. Like that. So there you are, got a little bunch of leaves coming off that branch, and then starting another branch. So there you are, that's another branch nearly complete. And then third branch, we just had enough to do three branches, and I'm going to fill in. There'll be odd ones. I'm going to don't have it too similar. I'm going out up that way. See, it's the line there. Going up, forward with the branch, and then down. So up, forward, down, and then that'll look really good. You don't want them. Some of these are coming off square, so I'm going to flatten the brush. You've got a little point on the end of the brush, and then look more realistic. There we are, that's better. Now what I'm going to do is, see, all that is the same kind of colour there, but what I like to do is mix it up with different, what we're going to use. You can either go darker, just adding a little bit of blue, which we'll do now, and then we'll go a bit lighter. So this is going to be some darker leaves. Be able to see these quite clearly. So that these would be like in the shade away from the sun rays. If you mix them in either in the gaps or over the top of some of these, so some over the top and some in between, depending where the light's catching it. There we are. It's going to be quite dark around this area here, I think. See where this area is, so I'm going to put a quite a few dark bits there. And as we come into the distance, where there's less light coming from the top where the sky is. It's going to get darker, but I'm going to put some of these medium colour, medium green, which has got blue, yellow, green. Just a bit more there. Good thing to do, actually. After you've done a few, you can actually stand away from the painting and just have a look what it looks like and where you want to go next. Because you can get so concentrated in putting the leaves down, you're not getting the whole overall effect. You know, when you stand up and you just splash on the. It's easy just to, like I did the background, it's easy to stand back and you put, oh, that's where it all goes. You can get almost a finish by just putting it on really quickly from a distance with a big brush, one of the big brushes. You can get that tunnel in and you can get those areas. You can get the dark bits and the light bits really quite quickly with a big brush. If you're concentrating on these, you can get so concentrated in one area, but it looks really good. You can put little, you can put little secret things in to get closer. Some people will hide their signatures. And also, if there's a branch or like a line on the branch, it doesn't look really good. Say there, we can cover it up like this and then do the leaves like that. And now this is all quite light here, really. Oh! You don't want to be doing that. Don't worry. But I can blow did that because just dab a bit of water. And then there you are. So you don't even have to worry. If you're not happy with a bunch of leaves, you can actually take them off. And actually, I don't like, because I haven't put much water on, paint on my brush, that group were. Wasn't so not so light leaf-like, so I'm gonna have another go at that, and then I'm gonna show you what I do next. Could be a bit too wet. No, it's all right. Now these leaves are much better. They look like realistic, and you just twist it and lift up quickly. Now look like leaves. That looks much better. That's it. In a dry there, that's better. Now that's all quite the same-ish there, look. So you add a bit of blue, Don't start up here where it's really dark. Start where it's dark and then come up into the lighter bits. You won't be able to see this until I've gone deeper in. So some of those leaves will be away from the sun, but can you see I'm taking it from the dark in there? I'm putting just little blobs rather than a bit of blue. Can you see that's darker there? Here we are. That's looking good now. And then taking this darkness into, so it's not all the same color and makes it look more realistic. And you can put the odd dark leaf in some of these light areas, and it gives it a bit of like, I don't know, depth, I'd say. Three-dimensional. So dark up into the light, and then so I'm happy with that there. Look away, yeah, that's good. I mean, not look away, go further back to look. I'm happy with that one, but if you, that's better, yeah, and then so that's going up this way, the leaves are going this way. Can you see the leaves are going that way? Those going up this branch here. That looks better. I think I'll have some more darker ones even further down. So I'm mixing up a bit more ultramarine down here. But I'm actually going to put some little blobs. Just little blobs. So it joins these up. And I'm going to have some even darker. So to go even darker, I'm going blue, bit of red. Blue, bit of red, make a bit of purple. And then there, that. I don't know if you can see. I'm just adding. So the leaves, some of them, are really deep in the shade. Also, it's good to have a mixture of colours. Makes it more. Oh, that's good. You can see what I'm doing. See the effect I'm getting? It's almost like this joins in with that. It's really dark around here, but you're not just having a load of light there and then medium and then dark. Really got dark, medium, light, but there's a mixture of one or two dark ones going right up here. So if I put one there, like that, you say that like that, balance it out like that. It gives a good contrast and makes it more colourful. Now you can see that this area is all more balanced now, and I don't think just leave that light there and just bring some more light out there. Add one couple of dark bits. I'm not actually always cleaning the brush, so some of the colours can actually mix in. Mix in with the other leaves. So they all it all actually joins. That's better, that's good. Sometimes you do something, you think, oh, that's good. If it's good, you can carry on. don't overdo it, but you can add a few more if you think that looks good. Now coming down here now. Yeah, some dark ones. Dark ones coming down here, so I'm going to stick with that colour. Which is like. Actually, I don't know what. There's so many are mixed in there. I don't know what colour it is. But there's purple up here, so what colour have I got? I've got red, blue. There's still some green on the brush. But generally, it'll be like a purpley colour. There. So actually, that purpley colour, I'm fading in. See, I'm coming further into the green bit. So this you can actually do. This is get more. It's more like an impressionist painting. Oh, it is an impressionist painting. That's the expression. It's expressing those leaves. How you want. See, I'm going up, got some dark, missing dark bits there. So I've faded that dark down here, it's a bit more there. Some of the leaves you can have closer to, so you just make them bigger. And we'll make this a 30-minute video. If you like this, just comment below or like, and I'll do some more tutorials like this one. Now, so that purple, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get in the last few minutes. I'm just going to do this. I'm going to put a block. I need blue. Blue, and I've got some red. Blue and red. Instead of mixing them to make purple, you can do this. I'm going to make that a bit so watery so it flows. I'm going to do this. I'm just going to use blue. Pure blue. If it's wrong, you can always blob over it. Phone's going, but that's right, let's carry on with this. So that makes it really. Oh, you can't see at the top there. Hold on, it's. Want to show you this because that's quite good. See, it's purple, mostly purple around here, but if I put some blue ones by themselves. They will look too blue, but mixed in with the purple, because the blue's close to the well, it's purple is blue and red. It looks really good. It gives you a good zing. So we can either go have it all greens, different shades of green, and or we can go, which is realistic, make it realistic kind of thing. You can even make it realistic completely. Or you can have like a colourful arty painting. And you can't go wrong really with this method. So the only thing can make a mistake is so you can make a couple of mistakes and they're not going to show up because you're doing so many. That's good. You go. Keep going up there. I want to go blue, a bit of green. So I'm gonna have more towards the blue, just a bit of green in. So See what that looks like. It's really deep, even more blue. So it hasn't got the pure blue coming out, but it's good strong blue there. You think, oh, are these blue? Oh, that's really, they're all colours really, if you look. See, the blue is coming from the sky above, and there's a lot of blue in the sky. And if they're wet, then they're going to reflect a lot of the blue sky anyway. So there is a lot of blue in shining off the leaves. Even though they're green, green's made out of blue and yellow anyway. But this bluey effect, if you mix it like, say you could have some blue, and then you have some green. If you, the further you stand away, that blue and that yellow mix in and says, oh, that's green. It makes it exciting, makes the painting more exciting to look at with all the colours as you get closer. There you are, I've got some blues in there now that are sort of like that now. So that's it, I think, for now. And hope you enjoyed that video. If you can like, subscribe, I'll do more like this, more tutorials on how to paint. I'll be painting in oils, acrylics, watercolors, and giving tips on what materials I'm doing and techniques, and actually just showing how my paintings. Oh, I should say, when I finish this, I can show a little video. I'm going to do a man and lady, because it's going to be called Love Tunnel, just here, little miniature, walking through with all the light shining through the tunnel, and I'll be picking out some of the colours to put in their clothes. Okay, this was Simon, and I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye for now.